Hey there, this is René Molenaar for GNS Threefold, and I want to show you how you can configure WCCP version 1. So in this lab, at the top I have a internet router, and in the middle we have a redirector, and that's where I'm going to configure the redirection of packets towards the webcache server on your right. I don't have a real webcache server. It's just a router that's going to represent this webcache server. And at the bottom we have a client router. Now if you're going to do your CCIE routing and switching, there won't be a real webcache server, but you still need to know the commands that we have to use. So I'm going to show you how to configure this, but there's no way for us to really test it. So I'm going to start at the redirector router, and all the commands that we need are at the IPWCCP level. So what I'm going to do is use webcache, and I'm going to use a redirect list because it says set the access list used to permit redirection, and I'm going to use number 100. And before I'm going to create the access list, I need to type in IPWCCP outbound ACL check. There we go. And let's create the access list. So deny, this is the network that I want to exclude. There we go. Access list 100, permit IP any. So this is the network that I'm going to exclude, and all the other stuff should be redirected. So that is the first step, and the last step is that we need to apply this to the interface. So I'm going to, well, there are two methods how we can do this. You can place it inbound or outbound. So let's do it inbound on this interface towards the client, and I'm going to type IPWCCP webcache redirect, and then I'm going to do inbound. That's it. And that's basically everything I can show you, because there's no way for me to test this. There are a couple of commands that we can look at. Show IPWCCP. It says global WCCP information, not yet determined. Well, there's nothing talking WCCP, but here it will show you the number of clients, routers, packets that are processed. But here you can at least see the access list that we have configured. And you can also check this on an interface level. Here you can see that I have applied WCCP to this interface inbound. But that's it. There's nothing much that I can show you here. But this is how you can configure WCCP version 1. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you next time.